Hi, this is Jason Molesky. In this example, we'll take a look at calculating a confidence interval for the slope of a regression line. Earlier, we used Minitab to perform a least squares regression analysis on the helicopter data for Mrs. Barrett's class. Now recall that the data came from dropping 70 paper helicopters from various heights and measuring the flight times. Some computer output from this regression is shown below. And recall, we checked the conditions for performing inference earlier, so we don't have to worry about doing that in this particular problem. Now, first of all, let's give the standard error of the slope, SE sub B, and interpret that value in context. Well, we get the value of the standard error of the slope from the SE coefficient column in the computer output. So looking in this particular column, we find the standard error of the slope by looking at the predictor drop height, and we see that it's 0.0002018. Now, what that means is if we repeated the random assignment many times, the slope of the sample regression line would typically vary about 0.0002 from the slope of the true regression line for predicting flight time from drop height. Next, let's find the critical value for a 95% confidence interval for the slope of the true regression line and then calculate that confidence interval. Well, because the conditions were met, we checked that in an earlier example, we can calculate a t-interval for the slope B based on a t-distribution with 68 degrees of freedom. We had 70 helicopters dropped. To calculate the degrees of freedom, we subtract 2 from our sample size. Now, using the more conservative degrees of freedom of 60 from table B, we get a T star critical value of 2.000. So then the 95% confidence interval for the slope would be our observed slope plus and minus the critical value times the standard error of the slope. We observed a slope of 0.0057244. Our critical value was 2, and as we saw in part A, our standard error of the slope is 0.0002018. Performing those calculations, we come up with an interval from 0.0053 to about 0.0061. So to interpret that interval in context, we can say that we're 95% confident the interval from 0.0053 to 0.0061 seconds per centimeters captures the slope of the true regression line relating the flight time y and drop height x of the paper helicopters. Now, what does 95% confident mean? Well, that means if we repeat the experiment many, many times and use the method in part A to construct a confidence interval each time, then about 95% of the resulting intervals will capture the slope of the true regression line relating the flight time and drop height of paper helicopters. For some additional practice in calculating a confidence interval for the slope of a regression line, try exercise 7.